Hello, hello, and welcome to a StarCraft 2 SEACast. This is up here where... Oh, wow. Hello, hello, welcome to another StarCraft 2 SEACast. I am your caster, System, and up here we are on Skakuras Plateau. And I have a nice little replay for you guys here. This is, in fact, INTIMELight up here at the top right as our red Protoss. Is a new clan INTIME and being sponsored by a... No, I'm not sure exactly whereabouts in Oz they are, but it's an internet cafe and they sponsor them. But you may remember him from nGenLight, still one of the pretty good Protoss on the C servers. But we are on Skakuras Plateau, top right, that is him. His opponent for today is Gosuro, playing as our blue Terran. Now, these two players are actually... This game is taken from the WCG in Sydney. That was just a few days ago, or was it last weekend even. And it was what... WCG Qualifiers. And that were being held in Sydney, in Australia. So this is one of the replays. I believe this is game two of their best of three series. I'm not sure what happened to game one, but I saw this replay and definitely wanted to cast it. So as we can see here, just the scouting SCV, gonna check the cross position first, and we'll find Light very last, but just double checking. And here comes Light throwing down a gateway on 12, and everything just be as normal and standard from both these players. Now, unfortunately, I haven't been kind of idle with my videos at the moment, but that is because I do in fact had to get an upgrade, as it was hard to stream, hard to record videos, as I still had a dual core processor, so that means my computer was shit. Either way, we are back, we have a quad core processor now, so everything's looking fine. Check out these mad graphics, whoop whoop, check it out. So everything looks beautiful and nothing is too fancy there. Apparently there is some sort of lag there and that there was a quick pause there, but everything looks okay to go as this is a replay. We did not have to sit through these pauses. That's a good thing from a replay. Light is just getting his gas, or it has just completed throwing dudes onto gas, getting a second pylon. We'll probably follow this up with a cybernetic core and just gonna transition into good old normal stuff as the SCV scouting coming in from Gosuro. And you will find that Light is just doing a normal build. No second gas just yet from Light, then he will want to check that, as he did. And now he's just going to back out. May even just hang around to see if there is a second gas, as nothing is being built from this gateway just yet. So Light's actually opting out for that initial Zealot. And over here, we see Gosuro just getting a Marine at the moment. Still getting Marines out of this barracks. And getting a command center. So it looks like he might be going for a 1-rack fast expand. Hasn't actually picked up any gas just yet, so it might be that, or it might be an all-in. We will have to wait and see. Back in Light space, still no second gas, so he could be going for foregate, or maybe something else, maybe just a bit late on his second gas, I'm not too sure. But this probe is going to move out. It looks like he is actually banking a ton of minerals, so he will go for that expo. As you can see, there we go. So his expo is down at the natural, and so is Gosuro's. So both these players going for a relatively fast expo, 1-rack expand from Gosuro, 1-gate expand from INTIMELight. And we'll look to follow up with more gates and some sort of tech path. We will have to wait and see. Probably just the standard Colossus coming from Light. And Gosuro, Marine Medivac, Marauders. Nothing too shabby about that. Throwing down a bunker, as he's quite vulnerable to any early Stalker pressure. Or just the Stalker to come up and see what's happening. Taking one gas as well. Continuing to pump Marines from this single barracks. Floating just a bit of minerals there at the moment. So could probably want to throw down a few more gases, but we will have to wait and see. And also getting a bit close onto the supply, but that is okay. Light throwing down two more gases, chrono boosting that walkgate research. And looks like that is the first Stalker. So Light actually doesn't have a single unit on this field at the moment. Actually, no, yeah, he doesn't have anything. So both these players, well, I suppose for Light, it is lucky that these Marines could do considerable amount of damage if they just waltz right in here. But Light is just getting that first Stalker, and that will be alright. Looks like it's rallied directly to a Zelnaga. No, directly to the front of Gosuro's base. And just for scouting purposes, I'd assume, there it goes, it's moving out. And the Nexus from Light is nearly complete. Three gates are still at the moment, transferring probes. We'll look to transform these as soon as possible, and the gas is complete. Now we'll have to see what his tech path is. It looks like Gosuro is throwing down four more barracks. So hitting up a grand total of five, as well as a tech lab on his initial barracks. So he's definitely going some sort of heavy Marine Marauder, maybe a really early Stim push with just pure Marines, judging by these barracks placements. But we will have to wait and see. Initial Stalker is going to run up the ramp, going to spot this bunker, and we'll leg out. There he goes. Didn't take any life damage, so that was pretty cool. And he's just going to back off from that at the moment. What's this? Just a probe, going to scout things out, I guess, for some proxy pylons as well. Maybe even want to hold that Zelnaga. But that is going to be all she wrote for that. Two still, two guesses, and a robo facility finally coming down to Light. I wouldn't really say finally, but it is now done. It's a nice scan from Gosuro. We'll spot both the Expresses as we do take division. Expo 1 and does spot just two gates at the moment, but he will know that there are going to be some sort of more gates. Well, you gotta assume the cup is just tickets. And that is gonna be it. Light's just gonna back on his main, just gonna check things out. Doesn't want to get rushed down here, as this is a really wide ramp, and it's quite hard for Protosses to force field that. So he's quite content to sit back on this ramp, and just be nice with a single force field. Throwing down more and more pylons to unsupply block himself, and getting his third gas as well. So this robot facility is gonna be in use some time, probably look for his Colossus as well. We'll have to wait and see. Still sitting on 3 gas though, no additional upgrades, or well, should I say a forge coming down just yet. But it is still early in the game. Taking a look at the harvesters, we are sitting at 33-29. Light does have that slight advantage there, but he is falling behind on the income because he does, one, have this third gas, and two, the turn has meals. But that is all right. It doesn't matter. Protoss do like their gas, so they'd quite happily trade some minerals for gas. And looks like actually all these racks are going to be moved. There's a tech lab and two reactors coming down. So unfortunately, Gosuro did lose some production time there while moving that, but that is okay. And actually, Gosuro is still sitting on just one gas, so whatever he's doing, it looks like he's not really looking to tech too hard. Might want to go for some heavy marine marauder play, but marauders don't really need that much gas to can constantly produce. Getting stim and combat shields as well. As well as an engineering bay. Interesting choice for an engineering bay there. I guess to throw down a forward missile turret to deny any scouting from an observer. But well micro and well, should I say, just paying attention to where your obs is. Can pretty much make sure you won't lose this, as the first observer from Light is going to come in and will have a scout as I hit the B button. Oh no! Oh man! That's okay. We're going to roll with it. Let's do it. We're rolling with it. So this observer is going to come in and will have a scout. I wonder if you can actually unmacro that. That sucks. But he's going to come in, spot a couple of supply depots, and we'll check that there is the engineering bay. I'm not upgrading actually, so he will probably notice that as it's not doing any animation. I'm just going to check out these mass racks. Absolutely, there's still no factories either. So that pretty much tells Light there is no Vikings, no tanks, no medevacs even for jobs. So he's pretty safe in his main. So as you can see, all of his units are now being moved to the front. A scan again coming down for Gosuro. Just want to check out what's happening in Light's base. Still sitting on two bases. His macro is extremely well. Look at this. Nothing staying too high. This tell this is a Grandmaster player. And this Obs is just going to sit here and keep an eye on what does come out of these barracks. And a little push coming out from Gosuro now. Well, actually just a single Marauder and a ton of Marines. They do have Stim, no 1-1 or anything absolutely at the moment, but a handful of Stalkers, some Zealots, and 3 Sentries. These Sentries are banking 150 plus energy, and it looks like the first Colossus is nearly out as well, so this could be not the best timing for Gosuro to attack. Plus 1, it has just been begun for him though, and Thermal Lance nearly complete from Light as well, but I don't know, some well-placed force fields can pretty much deny this small attack here, but here we go, we will see it. Gosuro will push up onto the ramp, Stim's a single Marine just to check things out. We'll force Light back just a little bit, but nice little macronade. Here comes the Stim from all these places. Nice force field right through the middle of the army. We'll clean up that army pretty easily and continues to force field behind these units. And oh my, everything from Gosuro is getting absolutely demolished here. And I don't even think Light lost a single unit. He lost all of his Zealots though, but everything else survived. And taking a look at the units lost, that was a huge mineral sink there for Gosuro. He is really far behind now. Income, it's still pretty even on harvesters, so both these players macroing pretty well. Unfortunately, Gosuro is floating just a bit of minerals. He did dump it just then, so that is good. Throwing down additional 4 racks, I think that was. Holy Jesus. Getting a second gas as well. Probably wants to get a factory in medevacs as soon as possible. I have no idea what he is trying to plan. Getting 3rd and 4th gas, as well as the 2nd, finally. So he looks like he's now going to tech really hard. Plus 1's nearly complete, though, and Light is now going to move out now that Thermal Lance is complete on these Colossus. He is devastatingly looking powerful. Still no upgrades, and I don't think a single forge has been placed just yet. Nope, just 2 gateways. A forge is now on the way, and that is a total of 4 gates. So he's only sitting on 4 gates and a robo, but still, he's doing pretty good on his macro. This little force from Light is just going to chill at the zone now. I just want to check things out, just make sure there's nothing too dangerous happening. And Gosuro is just having a ton of Marines. Even though losing all those Marines, being able to remax pretty quickly, thanks to these whole bunch of Raxes, is just pretty quite interesting actually. Observer does come in and we'll scout the more racks are being placed down. So I think that's enough for Light to back off. Throwing down a third as well. So does want to make sure he's well ahead in the macro, and he is just doing it as well amazingly. Double forge actually, so getting 1-1, chrono boosting it out as fast as possible. More and more Colossus are continuing to be built. And again, that Thermal Lance is still complete. Warping in Zealots and a single Stalker as these pylon placements for Light, look at that out at every possible expansion. And just all scattered all over the place, so we can see drops from this one here, medevacs wanting to swing around, just perfect placements of all these pylons. And Elb's gonna come in, check what's happening. Looks like the double starboard are gonna be lifted off onto these reactors. And assuming wanting to pump medevacs and Vikings as soon as possible. Let's see what come out of these. Vikings, medevacs, so a whole ton of Vikings. And actually ditching the medevacs, it's going mass Vikings. So this is interesting. More and more stims coming out from these units will just slowly kill themselves if they don't have medevacs to heal them. And Light's just going to take out the back destructible rocks and probably make another path of attack. Just to want to check things out. Even could get Blink and Blink up here. As we can see, there's no Twilight Council yet. Probably wants to throw that down. As we can see, it might be over here. There it is, Twilight Council, as well as two more gates. So the Twilight Council is going down to get 2-2. Continue the ups with that. And Harvesters again, 69-69. Both these units, should I say both these players, again, just keeping well on the income. And now Gosuro is pumping out Vikings like a madman. Currently sitting at 4 Vikings, so not that bad, but we just took our eye off the map down here for a quick second, and he is now up 4 Vikings. So the longer Light takes, the better this could be for him in terms of going to lose all these Colossus, and there isn't really that much of a ground army for Light. There is a ton of sentries though, so he's brilliant force field. He can really pump this out. And take a look at Gusuru's bio. He's just sitting at 1 attack, no armor, and 1-1 for Light is now complete, and he is getting 2-2 as well as charge for those Zealots. And I'm getting Blink after that, I would assume. So still sitting on 3 gates. What's this over here? 3 more gates going down. So there's a total of 9 gates. As he needs to burn his income, as he is now sitting on 3 bases. Could even throw down a 4th, but look at this. Holy crap. Whole ton of SCVs, Marines, and Marauders coming out. Vikings as well, doing some good damage against these Colossus. Not the best micro, I'd have to say. Look at this. Everything's just getting tunneled in here. Nice force field again from Light, but he's going to lose all of his Colossus thanks to these Vikings. Vikings are going to shoot down the Colossus, and there is still a whole ton of Marines and Marauders, and even all of these SCVs are pulled. Is this every single one of these SCVs? It is. Holy Jesus. So Light is being forced to retreat. He needs to pick these sentries off as soon as possible, but Light needs to get to a good choke. A scan up the ramp will spot. There are reinforcements, the second Colossus as well. Light even bringing his own probes down into the party. SCVs dying. Whoa, look at all this. Just gigantic ball of stuff. Not really micro, just going to sit there, but Light's just going to use it and lose it. And all of these SCVs, another stim out from this Marines. Remember, these guys are self-killing themselves. Void Rays! No, not the Void Rays. Vikings are going to slowly kill all the Colossus. And there is no more Colossus. There's just this one down on low health. Looks like it will get sniped by the Stalkers. No, actually, Light looks like he's in a pretty bad position here. It's pretty much all in. Gosuro is just even scanning his own units. I don't know what. Might have probably wanted to drop him here, but doesn't matter. He's going to push through and just... Will Light hold on to this? He's just got a handful of Stalkers left. Whooping in another round of Zealots. Pulling probes off as well. Taking a look at the Harvesters. It is 30-11. So if Light does hold this off, he will pretty much be in the economic lead, and Gosuro pretty much needs to fight himself. But it looks like, thanks to these amazing amounts of gateways, the reinforcements from Light will be able to clean this up, as well as Gosuro's non-Viking units. And Gosuro does call GG, and that is going to be all she wrote for this game. So thank you for watching.